Hello and welcome to Unplayable Trash. This game was recorded at the Hall of Heroes in Campbelltown and is round one of a local steamroller tournament featuring 24 players. My name is Tort and I'm going to be recording commentary here solo because my audio recording equipment hates me. Now, on to the game. On the left side, we have Cam the Dentist White. Hailing from Newcastle, Australia, Cam is a master cake baker and callus enthusiast. Through years of hard work, Cam has attained the ability to push Legion models around in a semi-coherent manner. Most of the time. And on the right side, we have Jeff Splinter Treish. Hailing from Campbelltown, Australia, Jeff is Australia's deadliest War Machine and Hordes player. A master of trolls and minions, Jeff was once voted most likely to say, "Hey, what does that model do?" before dying horribly. The matchup here is an interesting one. Val 1 is a master at tearing through Hordes list, but she doesn't like to see a lot of shooting, and Rask is packing a lot of guns thanks to the recent release of Croak Raiders. I think personally, I might have been tempted to drop Val 2 into this game. She does a lot better against the kind of shooting output Treishy can put out, and that trench is ideally situated for an Angelius to hide in. She can also deal better with Admonition, which can be an issue for Legion Heavy Beast lists. However, the Ravagor Scather templates do very little, and Rask is difficult to assassinate. And Val 1 is a boss, so I don't think it's a bad decision to take her. He'll need to be cautious though, and sandpaper off Croak Raiders. If he loses heavies early, it's only going to go downhill from there. From Treishy's side, I don't think there is any doubt about caster selection here. You take Rask. He's going to see a lot of beasts either way. He deals best with the Angel Defense with his Paralyze gun, and both Vals are excellent assassins, and Rask is a harder of his casters to kill.
The scenario for this game is Fire Support. Scenario 4 in the 2015 Steamroller pack. Both players are able to select their objective. Jeff has selected Bunker for this list, giving the objective Girded and Impervious Flesh. Girded is useless in this matchup, but Impervious Flesh means that Cam will be rolling one less die if he tries to kill the objective with Typhon Sprays or Seraph Shots. Cam's objective is Fuel Cache, which gives Beasts Within 4 inches a free charge, and will set Treish's model on fire if he tries to kill it in melee. This is a killbox scenario. You gain 2 control points if your opponent finishes their turn and their caster is completely within 14 inches of any table edge. The flags are slightly offset. The bottom flag is 1 inch closer to Treishy's side of the table. Treishy can only dominate that flag for a point, and Cam can control for 1 or dominate for 2. The top flag is closer to Cam. He can dominate for 1. Treishy can control for 1 or dominate for 2 control points.
Let's get Jack over here to check. Get Jack over to check that I've done the army right. What's the range on Croak Raiders? So it's 8 and 10?
Yeah.
Speed 5? 6. Oh, okay.
Those Croak Raiders are going to pose a bit of a problem for Cam. With advanced deployment, 6 in advance, and 10-inch range on their fire guns, he can't really afford to get too far forwards. Treishy can shoot his beast if he advances more than 9 inches, but needs to either forego the boost for oil or hope for a lucky AoE scatter, unless Cam advances 11 or more inches. I think I'd be tempted to get 10 inches forward here, put some pressure on Treishy, maybe try and tempt him into risking the Croak Raiders so he can get Typhon into them early.
Any advance?
No.
Looking at Cam's deployment, he has the Raptors threatening his friendly flag, with Vale and her beasts threatening the enemy flag. Typhon and the Seraph are set up closest to Vale, and Anissa is on the opposite flank of the Raptors. This is normally a good deployment idea when you're going first. Anissa and the Raptors are both looking for similar targets, and this way your opponent has to present at least one of them with good targets. In this game though, it's not going to matter as much. They're both going to have too much to shoot at. Treishy has deployed centrally, with both Croak Raider units ahead of Bokors and the Vault in position to catch everything. Rask is fairly far back. He could be more aggressive, but he really doesn't have to at this stage.
Let's put all the spears that side, so we know the spears are on the edge of the unit, and a different one on the other one. Where's the leader? There's two leaders by the looks of it. There's one. The guy that's broke his arm off. Sorry, I can't tell where the leader is. One leader. Is there another model like that? Nope.
Nope. Oh, he's got a big fat mouth, has he?
Yeah, and he's got the flame. It'd be the one that's broken. That's why. That was a bit of a pain, wasn't it? 3, 6, 8, 10.
Alright. My prey will be I'll screw it, that unit.
Yep.
Don't care. Alright, so she'll run.
Mm-hmm.
Preying a 10-man unit can be a bit of a risk, because your opponent can just run one model to the edge of the table where you can never kill them, and therefore never cycle your prey. But in this case, it's probably still a good move. Those Croak Raiders really need to die.
This unit's gonna run.
Mm-hmm.
Assume AOE position.
Cam's being very cautious here with Anissa and the Raptors. He kinda needs to be with the threat those Croak Raiders pose, but Anissa at least has stealth. He could have gotten further forward with her.
Val's going to activate. She's going to cast Leash 2. Yeah, it's 2. On to Typhon. Going to got 6. Did it? Shoot tenacity yourself.
This is a very different play from Cam than what I like to do when going first with the Bale, which is to drop 5 or 6 Fury and run straight at my opponent. It's partly dictated by the Croak Raiders, but I do wonder if the cautious approach here is just going to give up board position to Tracy.
Set up wrong, so she'll just camp couple.
Just going to speed up Cam here running his beast.
He's just going to advance. He'll put up his Animus, which mm-hmm. is the D3 healing.
Yep.
She tenacity of herself. Tenacity of that one. See if I can math. 1, 2, 6, 8, 9, 2, 6. How can I math this morning? Doing this right? 5, 7, yes. There we go.
Okay. 6 Fury, see how many the Vault gets. 3.
I'm going to speed up Tracy's very exciting running here as well. He's being very aggressive here, taking a lot of board position with the Croak Raiders. However, while he is currently in threat range of a lot of Cam's models, if Rask feats, his entire army is going to be completely safe.
I'll do inhospitable grounds. So a couple of yours don't get Pathfinder, isn't there?
Just him. Everything else has Pathfinder.
Inhospitable ground for three. Off feet. I'll charge him.
Even though there's only one model it will affect, inhospitable ground is really important in this match. If Cam is going to win, he needs to get work out of Typhon.
Get spiny growth on him for two. Roll for one. Six. Put Zombify on those guys. Ten.
Okay. Sorry, I'll look at the bloody leash.
This looks to be a good turn from Tracy. He's taken a lot of board positioning, and he's threatening really far while being pretty safe because of his feet. With the damage output of those Croak Raiders, Cam really can't afford to leave his models in range, but he also can't afford to back up and concede the scenario. Croak Raiders here are just causing a lot of problems, allowing Rask to project force from the start of the game with their advanced deployment, and here really amplifying the effect of Rask's feet.
It's great having a bigger penis in your castle.
Yeah, it's handy, isn't it? At least you can
say. So, inhospitable grounds, you start about here-ish.
Yep.
There's not much Cam can do here. Tracy's handed him a shit sandwich, and he just has to decide how he's going to eat it.
Just start with this one.
This is a Nissa Cam is activating.
First shot at him.
See if you're within five.
Yep.
Yep.
Hits.
Yep.
Poison. Power 12.
It's in range of that. And in range.
Snap fire. I think I've stuffed that one up. So yeah, he's dead. So 13. 17 in that vote for those two guys. That's annoying.
Yes, 17, yep.
Yep.
Those Raptors will be getting the veteran leader bonus from Anissa, which is +2 on their two hit rolls. You'll often hear people say that it's a good idea to have Anissa across the table from the Raptors because it makes it easy to get the veteran leader bonus, but it doesn't matter where she is. Raptors should never miss out on the bonus. Even if she's directly behind them, face them sideways. They have light cav moves, you can change their facing after they've finished murdering dudes.
Back a bit. He's going to try and shoot at him. Yep.
Yep.
In right, line of sight to her, so they're at 9. Hits, poison power 10. That guy's dead. The guy who's not in cover, I am just out. Right, I have a punt at that guy there. I'm in.
Yep.
I'm rat 9 because of her, so catch 8. It's an 8. Poison power 10. That was dead.
As a Legion player, I think that Raptors should have native stealth. And while we're at it, why not? Hunter and, fuck it, Snapfire. Raptors, after all, are unplayable trash, as famously declared by Jeremy Shea, who is the unofficial mascot of this video series. Just going to play some thinking music here for Cam.
Thank you.
doesn't seem worth it. This is probably going to be a mistake. We'll see what happens. Scythian is going to go... Yeah, just going to go up on the hill.
Mm-hmm.
I think my play here would be Tenacity or the Beast, and then use the hedge and the wall to try and see if you can keep them safe.
Tenacity the Scythian. Vale is camping 7 at the moment, so I just upkept leash. Just going to Tenacity herself. She's going to Tenacity Typhon. She's going to Tenacity him. That's not a Tenacity token. That is. No. Measuring kill box.
Game highlight here is coming up. You're all going to get to see me make a judge call.
Forgot to move Typhon.
Hey?
I forgot to move Typhon.
Yeah.
I think I'm okay, though, if I move right up into base-to-base with him. There's 14. I just imagine like that.
Just get torture check it up.
Do you want to check this? Should we pause it? So, measuring the kill box, I want to nudge up Vale to there. Do you think if a base goes there?
No, definitely not.
Right.
He's a handsome man, that Tort. Handsome, charming, great rules judge. Just a fantastic bloke all around.
He just said, speeds like a charge. So she's just going to go for a walk. She speeds 6. Join the kill box. He's going to do his dingo move just a little bit. So, what is she camping? She was started on 7. She put out 3 tenacities. Camping 4. Vicious there. Just going to fly over the hill. Oh, I got one.
Is the time going?
Oh, shit. No. Sorry.
That's okay.
Six. Roll for one.
This is a slow turn from Cam, and he hasn't managed to achieve much with it either.
So many Madoos going to die next turn, Tracy. I hate you. This guy's going to Ryle for one.
I'm just happy they're stalling so much beer.
Well, Legion Beasts just die so easily, and yeah. What the problem is, I would have been happier pushing forward, but I just, with inhospitable ground out, I can't get the value out of coming backwards.
Yep.
Because I could go out there and spray a few things, then he dies very easily. So it's sort of how much hurt you can put out next turn. Israel gonna run. Let's check math. 3, 7, 8. Chef is gonna move back a bit. That's everyone activated. Not my most convincing of performances.
I think Typhon could be better placed here, and where he is, he's just going to die.
Okay. So the get these up first, two on that unit.
Mm-hmm.
The white stripes. And one on that unit.
Maybe we'll have to order some croak raiders from Europe, Tracy.
Sorry?
Maybe I will have to order some croak raiders from Europe too.
Yeah. They're cheap enough anyway, really. They got the...
So Tracy's major objective this turn, I think, has to be to kill Typhon. Typhon, I think, is the key to Cam staying in this game.
So he's got Tenacity on him?
Yeah, Tenacity in the wall.
And so what's... It's plus two for the wall.
Yeah, it? Yeah, it's concealment hedge.
Gets him up to defense.
15. 16. Jeff 13 heavy, goes to 14 with Tenacity, goes to 16 with the wall.
It's 13, okay.
Yeah, 13 base. You hit him once, he dies though, because he's up on paper.
Yeah.
With Leash already upkept on Typhon, I think you can keep him further back, and he can still contribute to this game. Problem is, Tracy just has so many tools. He's got Victor Pendrake there to give the Croak Raiders boosted shots. He's got Rask with his paralyzed gun. There's just a lot of ways that he can make sure that he can get Typhon off the table here.
He'll boost a shot, make him defense 7.
The, Rat 7, so 9.
9, yep. Hits.
Yep.
So defense 7. I'll put ammunition on myself.
Okay.
You don't have any way of removing upkeeps, do you?
No.
Tracy has positioned Rask very aggressively, but with Call to Sacrifice, with admonition, and with the Croak Raiders and Bog Trogs, which are going to swarm up around him, it does seem still that Cam's going to have a lot of problems being able to kill him.
Yeah, this will go next. Defense 14, so eight. I need 8 to hit.
What are you doing?
Just throwing the spear.
Yep.
Armor is 15.
Yep.
Yeah. Hits.
Yep.
Power 12.
Neck 3.
Drops him. That was a big shot. This one on this one. Nope. This guy. Hits. Neck 3. 5, kills him. This one on him. Misses. The leader. Yeah, we'll go on him. Hits. Make 3. 3 wounds.
Mm-hmm.
This one. Yeah, this guy at him.
I'll see if he dies.
Misses. Okay, this one will throw the oil.
Where at? Oh, him?
At him, yeah.
So death 10.
Hits.
Yep. Nobody.
So, yeah. This guy will shoot him. Hits him. Power 12. Armor is...
18 with Tenacity.
18.
7-2.
7-2. And you're on fire, of course.
Is he on fire too, or is it just with oil?
No. No, any hit's fire.
Right.
Yeah.
Just to correct Tracy here, any hit is not fire. The oil attacks do not cause continuous fire. Also, Croak Raiders have torn apart the Raptors. As Jeremy would say, unplayable trash.
Range 12. Let's shoot him first. Range 12, no problem. I'll boost to hit him.
Mm-hmm.
I've got 5 on this. Just putting wherever you think.
He's putting on dudes again.
Hey?
He's putting on dudes again.
Oh, was I? Boosting to hit him. 9s. Hits him.
Neg 1. Power 13 gun, isn't it?
Yeah. Neg 1, 3 to kill him.
Yep.
Kills him, I'll spend 1 to take control of him.
Yep.
And I'll move him up to him. Makes an attack.
Mat 6.
There's an 8.
Hits. Stop rolling 8. Weapon master. Neg 5. Yeah. Dies now?
He dies.
Command check.
Okay. These guys are next. No, I won't do them next. I'll do these. I'll move up. Beast Law.
Mm-hmm.
Just in case. I will move. That's a flag, right?
Yep.
Tracy taking no chances here. Beast Law from Pendrake means the Croak Raiders will be rolling 3 dice to hit Typhon, needing 4s.
Okay. Start with him.
Hits. It's 3 dice to hit, too. Oh, Beast Law. Yep.
Neg 5, you said?
Armor 18, so neg 6.
Neg 6. There's 5 wounds for 3. I'll just mark them as I go. Next one. Hits. 4 wounds to 2. Do this guy next. 10's fine. Number 3. Hits. Next 6. There's 9 to 5.
He has 5 left.
This
you gonna die.
Hits. Next 6. There's 8. Watch him.
Dead.
5 left. Use
something like that.
Well.
You got 1 or 2 shots on him from the other Croak Raiders. Yeah, 1 shot in because you oiled him.
Yeah.
Then you shot him, so it was 5.
Yeah. So you got 2, 4, 5 left.
Mm-hmm.
So on him.
Death 14 on the hill.
Yep. So 8. Hits him with the oil.
Okay. Should have told me what one that was.
Sorry?
Should have said what one that was.
Oh, I always do oil first against beasts.
Okay.
Sorry. Next one.
Nope.
3 to go. Hits. Armor.
Shouldn't you have done 2 then? Because you had those 4 used, kill Typhon, then you oiled 1,
2.
Then you missed the next shot.
So that's this one, yeah?
Yeah.
Armor.
18.
Neg 6 is 9 wounds to 3.
Mm-hmm.
Next one. Misses, I think. Would you say you're death 14?
Death 14 on the hill.
Misses. Last one. Hits.
Mm-hmm.
Neg 6.
Neg 7. Actually, because of tenacity. So I'm going
to
heal one.
Is 7 wounds to 1. And he's suffering fire.
Yep. Fire.
Okay. These will go next. I will run. Spiny growth on him too.
Spiny growth on Rask there. Tracy continuing to take no chances.
He will run for 1. Move up 6.
How does this guy's sacrifice thing work again?
Just any model he can sacrifice to any model within his command.
Okay.
Yeah. So it counts as a wound. Say you do 5 wounds, I could sacrifice 5 of them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yep. So Pause.
Yep, and that was turn.
Okay. Nothing to upkeep. Fire. Okay. Fire on... Just him.
Yep.
Goes out.
Little bit of luck there for Cam with the fire roll going out. Thanks to oil from the Croak Raiders, the fire roll damage is also boosted. Cam really needs that little bit of luck. It's not looking good for him at the moment.
You didn't tough any of them, did you? No, just them. Okay. Yeah. Not looking good.
They add a different thing to the game, don't they, with the Gators?
Yeah. Jask can't kill Rask, because he'll dispel anything I shoot at him. And he'll add no away. Go backwards a bit. Whoops. Gonna shoot that one.
Yep.
Hit. Poison power 12.
So that's within 10, it is. It's one for him.
Snap fire into that one.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Hits. Dead.
One for him.
Light cab. Def 12 in that?
Normally def 10.
So def 6, def 14.
14, yeah.
She's in line of sight.
Yeah.
Shoot at him. Rat 9. Hits him. Power 10. He will shoot at that one. She's in line of sight. Rat 9. Hits. Poison.
Yep. So it's that one.
Was it that one? Yeah, it was that one. Yeah, sorry. Yep. Slipstream.
This is maybe a mistake, activating the Seraph before Val can put out Insight, but also it might not be a fantastic idea for Val to be that far forward to be able to affect the Croak Raiders by Insight.
This one here is going to strafe. That one?
Yep.
D3 plus 1. 4 shots.
Yep. Rat is
5.
Eight.
So first shot boosting and hit him.
Yep.
So how do I allocate this?
You have to say how many shots are going on each model, as far as I know.
Alright, 1-1-1-1-1.
Okay, so one of each.
So first one. On that one?
Eight.
Nope.
One behind him.
Yep. So I'll boost this one.
This one.
Boost that one. Yeah, power 12. Boost that one.
No.
Come on!
It's pretty bad dice.
It's not ideal. Veil is going to activate. She's going to... put up Insight. Leash is going to be enough. So Insight's up. He's going to put Leash up on him.
I can't be 100% sure without having asked at the time and running the tournament. I wasn't able to ask at the time. But I now assume the reason that the Seraph activated before Val cast Insight
Move up.
Was because he needed to slipstream that Cillian over in order to get it within leash range.
Using leash. Now, would I have ended up technically closer to her? Yes. She'll use her auto-hitting dart on that one.
Mm-hmm.
So power 12. He's dead.
Yep.
It's a power 8 that goes up to 10 with insight, not 12. That's a bad cam.
Off feet, if I haven't already said that.
It's the cat and mouse one, isn't it?
Yeah. The Scything on the hill here.
Yep.
Is going to put up his animus. What does it matter? I won't put up his animus, so we'll just charge. That one?
Yep.
With Cam committing his Scythians, he really needs to get those Croak Raiders off the table. The feat offers some protection from the Bokors, but it won't protect him from the Croak Raiders.
So him. Not him?
Mm-hmm. He hasn't lost any aspects, has he?
That's a good question. No. Mad 8. He dies. Second attack, mat 8. He dies. Fine attack, mat 8.
Misses.
12 miss. Fine attack. Imp. He dies. Fine attack.
Fuck's sake.
Alright. This one's tied to the vault.
I'm immune to the thing because of my
yep.
objective.
Yep. Charging the vault, so measuring 11. Easy. So, gonna move your, can you move your tokens for me, thanks?
There are still a lot of Croak Raiders left, and looking at the position of that Scythian at the bottom of the screen, he may still be in charge range of that Bokor even after the feet move, thanks to Boundless Charge and Elasticity. This hasn't been a good turn for Cam. A game that was already looking quite bad has really started to get away from him. I'm not sure now what he can do to get back in the game, other than to start looking for an assassination.
Yay, Scything. Your death, basically nothing. Hits.
Yep.
Power 17.
Neg 3.
Cocked. 5.
Yep.
You haven't got spiny girls on that one, do you?
Nah, I don't.
Second attack. Oh, I saw the one that freaked out. Hits. Neg 3. One. Why don't need a column.
No, you don't need a column.
Bloodbath, so I get those two guys. Yep. Mat 6. Miss.
Nope.
Mat 6.
Yep.
Yep, cool. The thing hits. Neg 3. Doing no fucking damage to this guy. 5. Fine attack on it. Hits. Is it worth boosting? I can get 2 more attacks, or I can get 1 fully boosted. Sure, I'll boost this one. 7.
7, 4, and 3.
Last one.
Yeah.
Hits.
2 left.
Come on! Yeah! I'm killing things!
You are indeed.
Do-do-do. Tenacity on the Veil. Strip that. Strip that. Nuts. Feet turn, cat and mouse moves.
Yep.
Cam here is unable to pull both Scythians back far enough to keep them safe, so he's pushing one forward and one back, hoping that he doesn't lose both. Vale's being very careful to keep herself out of the kill box. I don't think Cam has done enough damage here. I think Tracy's going to just tear him apart next turn.
So, he was maxed. Vale's on 3. And she got Tenacity from Mr. Shredder. Back is a bit. Mr. Shredder gonna go backwards a bit. She's gonna go backwards a bit. Shepherd can hang out. It's my turn.
Okay. Good turn.
Reasonable.
So bodies he gets 2. So that's the one. Two. This one gets 2, 4, 6.
Trace's objectives this turn are to kill both Scythians and not die. If he can do that, the game's pretty much in the bag. Tracy has nothing to upkeep because he used his admonition move last turn.
He'll put boosted shots on them.
On which guys? Ball. Which guys?
These ones.
This okay. Student. Yep.
What do I do with it there? They'll go first. That's the wounded one, yep.
Yes.
There are enough Croak Raiders left alive here that I don't think Tracy needs to use the Bokor, which is even worse for Cam.
So that's part of that unit.
Yep.
This one, oil first.
Yep.
Hits.
Yep.
So just mark them as we go.
Mm-hmm.
Next one. Hits.
Next 6 this time.
Next 6. Nothing.
You can have a fire back though. It's corrosion.
Hits.
4-2. It's got 11 left.
This one. 12.
Def 11. So yeah, hits.
Next 6. 2-3. So it's 1, 2, 3. I just did him, didn't I?
Yep.
It's 4. This one. Objective.
Oil, I assume. Oil it. Yep.
Hits it.
Yep.
The other one.
Push, next 6.
12.
Sure.
12.
So, how many is that left then? 3? How many wounds have we got? 15?
Oh, yeah. And it's on fire. Fire token too, though.
Can you set objectives on fire?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, these guys are going to stand still. So the first one here.
Yep.
Hits. Next 6. There's 3. 2.
He's got 5 then.
2 to go. Next one. Rat 8, 11 is a hit. Is 5 to 2. What's in?
Do you have RFP?
No, not that I know of. Last one, might as well have a shot at Vale.
Mm-hmm.
Defense is
18.
18. So I need a 10. Ooh. Oh, 5.
So at this stage, you'd be expecting the Legion player to start looking for assassinations. The problem is with Rask, you need to clear out the shamblers around him before you can actually kill him, and Cam just doesn't have the volume of attacks here.
He will... I'll put Fury on him too.
Onto who?
Onto the back wall.
Yep.
Fury's an upkeep, isn't it?
Yes.
I'll hit you with my blade.
Mm-hmm.
At 6, I need a 5. Hits. I'll boost damage.
Power.
Power 11.
Next 7.
Yep, that was good. Makes up for me triple 6. I'll sit on the 3. Okay. These guys will go next. They get a charge order. So mm-hmm. He's going there.
Yep.
He'll go that way. That way.
Does the Boker... Oh, too late.
Huh?
So did the Boker have line of sight?
Yes.
Okay.
I'll make sure that's there. Yeah. Okay, def 11.
Yep.
I need 5s. Misses.
I think that's 6.
Yeah.
Oh, back arc.
Back arc, yeah.
Oh, you're rolling with Boker, are you? Okay.
Yeah, I should have done it the other way around, but anyway. Hits.
What's this
power,
now?
Second attack is power... Power 10, so he goes to 13.
Yep, neg 5.
I'll boost neg 5, you said?
Mm-hmm.
6 wounds to 4.
Mm-hmm.
Buys an attack. Misses. Buys an attack. Buys an attack. Hits. First damage. Power 15.
Mm-hmm.
Neg 3.
Yeah.
11 wounds to 5. Buy an attack. Hits. First damage. Neg 3. And 6 to 2. How many left?
4, 7.
7 left?
Yep.
7 left. Buying attack. Boost damage. Drops it.
I think I can leech one. No soul.
Oh, no soul for killing him?
Yeah. Does he get corpse though? Is it corpses or souls that he collect? Should be corpses.
Corpse.
Yeah, then he gets a corpse. Ah, no, that's why he's falling over. Alright.
Okay.
Seems bad.
Hey?
It seems bad for me.
This unit will go next. And we'll run. We will put Zombify on them.
Mm-hmm.
We will put Spiny Growth on him. Two. Yeah. They'll run for one.
Okay. Fire. Goes out.
Hey, at least Cam's fire rolls are going out. I mean, that's something, right?
These three, so you know, the two different units?
Yep. There. Rat, 10, 13. Wish him a prey.
Yep.
Bow 12. Dead. Next shot, guy behind. Chuffed again. Bow 12.
Tracy has just played a really good game here. He's been cautious with his pieces, he hasn't overcommitted, he's been able to leverage the threat range of the Crow Craters, he's got great use out of his feet, he's got great use out of all of Rask's abilities here. It's just been a really top performance. He'd started off as, I would say, a good matchup for Tracy, but he's turned it into an absolutely dominant one, just with high quality play.
Vale's gonna cast Leash.
Yep.
It's looking pretty bad.
Crow Craters made such a difference.
Yeah, I lost Typhon too easily. I should have protected him better. I should have put him further back.
He's the one that can do the most damage.
He's the one that's, yeah, against this infantry spam.
Yeah.
And that's, it's been pushing shit uphill ever since then.
So the fire went out there, didn't it?
Yeah, yeah. She'll tenacity him. Tenacity herself.
Oh, it's panic for this bloke too.
Right, well, she's just going to turn. Leash. She'll use her auto hitting thing on him, and she'll boost the damage. Power 8.
Yep.
Dead. That can be the new prey.
Yep.
Just do checking with her. Right, he's going to aim, strafe him. The one here.
Yep.
So four shots.
Yep.
So the intention is to want to put it to there, so he's in range, and he's in two, so they're all going to get one.
Yep. So Rat is...
Seven.
Seven
under aiming.
Sixes.
So I'm going to boost all the shots.
Yep.
Hit. Dead. Power 12, actually. So what armor are they? Armor 12.
Armor 14.
14?
Yeah, 14.
Okay, now he's dead.
Yep.
That hit, so he's dead. Hits. He's dead. Hit. And he's dead.
He's out. That one gains one. And he'll be too far from that as well, I gather. Oh no. He's
got 8-inch stick. Yep.
Thank you.
Aim. She's on a hill, line of sight.
Yep.
Hits, poison. Dead. Hits, poison. Power 10, yeah, 16.
Yep.
Dead.
Even though Cam has finally chewed through those Crow Craters, they're all just going to come back as shamblers now. And Cam just doesn't have the volume of attacks to finish them off.
Fight curve. Shepherd. Strip that.
This has actually been a really good turn from Cam. It's just that he's in such a bad position that even a really good turn isn't going to be enough.
Tenacity on her.
Mm-hmm.
That was dumb.
Put yourself out of the
game. Can I do that? Can I do that more than once?
What?
Oh,
on the same model.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have a clue.
I have a read.
Now, Vale is in range here to be charged, but there really isn't a place on the table where he's going to be out of range.
No, it looks like it can, because a recondition, it says target friendly warbeast. The warbeast is in range. Place any number of fury points on it or remove the fury. End of it. But look at medicate. A medicate, you blah, 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 and it says a warbeast can only be affected by medicate once a turn. So, now I'm going to stick three on him so I can still transfer to him.
Yeah.
All right. New prey can be, I don't know, them.
Right. What's the defense?
16 at the moment because it's tenacity.
16. Okay, so he gets three. That's the large white ones. This one gets two, four, five, seven. They have the fury, upkeep fury. One.
Looking at the video here, I think that Bokor might be in range to charge Vale, which might be game over.
He will put Beast Law on him. Whoever's going to. Unit?
Yep.
He'll move up here. Put elasticity on him.
If Tracy runs that second unit of Shamblers over, he can use both units' Shamblers to buy and boost from the one Bokor. Then he's got more than enough Shamblers to kill Vale.
Right. Put Boundless Charge on him for two.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like he's going for it. I think Cam's only remaining hope here is just to get a really good Dark Sentinel roll.
Okay, this unit will charge. Slash one.
Oh my god.
He will charge faster.
That might be the first real mistake from Tracy, not activating the other Bokor unit first.
I'll get it. I'll just run.
Mm-hmm.
Charge.
You can get either A, they'll give me for two, or
charge. Charge, you get 12 inch straight.
Yep. Alright, so this thing's going to do, switch it to me.
Yep.
I'm gonna do my, Dark Sentinel move.
Yep.
He's neg one defense at the moment, isn't he?
Yep.
And he's still living?
Yep.
Alright. So, move into him.
Yep.
Fully boosted Stinger.
Yep.
Matt, six. That's a crit if I hit you. What's your defense? 11 at the moment, isn't it?
11.
Hit, so it's a crit, so it's a poison, so it's an extra dice, and it's fully boosted.
Yep.
Power strength 14. Armor?
16.
Neg 2. So, 12. That many.
So you'll take 7.
And then another 5 die.
Lose 5. Yep. So go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh, I love that Seraph, so Matt 6.
Good. Rest of the unit. Run. So these two on your caster, Matt 7.
Death 16.
9s. On him.
Death 15. Matt 6, does he?
Matt 6, yep. Hits. Power 15.
Armor 17.
On the 17.
Negative.
4 to the 5. Second attack. Miss. Fine attack. Hits.
Yep.
Boost damage.
Yep.
Power 15. Armor 17, aren't you?
Yep.
I won't boost damage. What's your defense?
15.
Nines. Nah, I will.
You got corpses for days.
Yeah. 10 to the 2.
Ouch.
I'm not sure it's the right move attacking the Seraph. Val's only one higher defense, and she's got a lot less armor.
Hits.
Yep.
Have any left?
Not very many.
I won't boost damage. Neg 2.
So wait, this six. Is 8, 6, to which column?
To the 4.
He's got 5 left.
5. Hits.
Mm-hmm.
How many left? 5?
Yeah.
There's 7. Nope.
2 points. What was that, 5? Whatever.
Hits. What? You want me to reroll this?
Whatever. A die. It's fine.
Need 2. Drops him.
Tracy's just having a bit of a think here about whether or not he wants to start spending shamblers trying to boost and hit a defense 16 Veil.
Is the only beast left?
Yep.
On bye.
Tracy, moving at old man speed. It's very exciting.
What's your armor?
Paper. Like 13 or something. I've got tenacity up, so maybe it's 14. 14.
10's to hit. Hits. Power 15.
So dice plus 1.
Dice plus 1. I'll boost.
Yep.
That's 12 wounds.
So transfer the shepherd, the shredders on 1.
On 1. On buy and boost.
Yep.
10's. Hits. Dice plus 1, was it?
Yep.
6 wounds. It's 8 wounds, sorry.
8 wounds, so she takes 7, because I'll blow him up, and she cops 7 back on her.
Yep. I'm not sure Tracy had attacked with the shamblers that charged the shredder either.
And I gain a soul. Do I get a soul from him, Don?
No, it's not. It's a corpse, if it was in command 8, though.
Yeah, it will be, because I have the...
Okay.
Okay. This unit will go next, and they will run slash charge.
As we speed up the proceedings here, we can see my beautiful hand just getting some confirmation on what had happened. When I had left the table to go deal with other stuff in the tournament, Cam hadn't looked quite this dead.
He will run. Move. It was on before then.
Which one did he zombify? Okay. Because he hasn't got any left in his unit now, does he?
Correct. But he can use these.
Yep. Okay, sacrifice to them?
Yep. I can sack them, I can use them to buy. Does everything like you were the other guy. It's pretty good. That's why the two units come in so handy.
Minions OP!
What am I gonna do? He's going to... Actually, you're def 11. Well, he's gonna move out like a bit further away. Still in the back arc.
Yep.
Shoot him.
I'm not sure if elasticity lasts more than a...
I think it's just a turn.
Hey?
Pretty sure it's just a turn.
I'm not sure.
Oh, he's going to be a packer.
Game's reach us for one turn.
Yeah. Yep. Right, so shooting at him. Get out a hit.
Yep.
Poison power 12, so neg 4 against you. 9 damage.
I'll just take it.
Cool. I'll switch my prey at tenacity. To that. Check range. Snap fire onto him. Yep. Hits. Poison power 12. Armor.
Armor's 14, I think. So how much?
It was 14.
14.
8 for 3.
8 for 3. Dig out his body.
Again, as I've speed up Cam's thinking time, Tracy here is just confirming with Cam that he gets the corpse for the Bokor who had just died.
I totally could have charged. Oh, didn't. Him.
Yep, 13.
Rat 9.
Yep.
Poison power 10.
Then 4.
4 to 1. To 1 it was.
4 second. To 1.
Yep.
So he's mine.
And then 5 to the 4. Punch that one. Yeah.
Tough.
Oh. Gonna charge him. Whee. Probably hit. Probably tough.
Dead.
Yeah.
More dead than he was before.
Bale had 5 on her, didn't she? Five, six. Should have cut myself. Just why the fuck not? Let's go full yellow, mate. Whee!
Here he comes.
Auto hitting dart, power 8. Equals armor.
18.
What I could do. Fully boosted Hoarfrost.
Same.
Fully boosted Hoarfrost time. Hit, doesn't crit you. Boosted damage, power 14. Power 14, so straight dice.
Yep.
Come on, 7.
We've got 2, 4, 5, 7, 9 left.
Boo! Follow. 3. There we go.
There's going to be one on each. Spirit and combine.
Do you want to play it out?
It's up to you.
So...
he goes in and kills you.
Yeah.
Cam there, just trying to squeeze out some army points with the game already lost. Thank you all for watching. There are more games coming, even though my audio equipment is trying to kill me. You can find us on Facebook or Twitter, or just follow the channel on YouTube. Special thanks to Cam and Tracy, two of my favourite Warmer Hordes people. Catch you all later.